grace, mercy, and peace to you, Jesus. Amen. Our text for this morning's consideration is from Paul's letter to the Philippians, as he writes it in prison. To die is gain, to live is Christ. Here he's in prison, and he's writing, it's a letter marked by joy. He's writing that this is all working out for the good. I am encouraging my brothers and sisters in the faith to be courageous in their witness as they're seeing me be courageous. I'm encouraged by them as they're praying for me. My imprisonment is helping the local church to be more courageous in their witness. And furthermore, those who are imprisoning me now know of the Christian faith. They've seen a Christian. God is glorified in all this. But then he wonders, what will happen to him? He is in prison. He might be executed. And he says, to die would be gain. But to live would be Christ. I have fruitful labor yet to accomplish for the benefit of you, the church. Isn't that amazing, this tension? We understand this call to Christ, to be with Christ, to die, to be gained. But there's a great, powerful pull to have fruitful labor, to be used by God. To pay attention to that. To die is gain. First of all, we can start out there as Christians. To die is gain. Do all of you know that? I hope you do. I think there's something in each of our hearts where we might doubt it or might be panic-stricken a bit at certain times in our life when facing death. But to die is gain. You have an inheritance, eternal inheritance, promised for you, where neither moth, rust, or thief can ever break in and steal or destroy. It is for you. It's your treasure. It's a promise. It's been given to you because Christ emptied himself for your gain. He came to our place, died on the cross that we might have life, rose from the dead, signifying the same thing will happen to each of us. We will be given life, eternal life. We will be with Christ. And that will be our gain. It is the glory that awaits you and I. It's a promise from God. He accomplished it. Do you have faith in that promise? Do you believe it as Paul does? To die is gain. We've got nothing to fear. Everything to look forward to. That is the great gift that I want to share for sure with you this morning. Salvation unto us has come. To die is gain. To be with Christ. But Paul also says, but I've got an earthly life here, as brief as it may be, on this side of heaven. And I want to do fruitful labor. I want to live as Christ. Can you relate to that? To live as Christ. He has loved you into the kingdom of God, and now we want to reflect that love and love others into the kingdom of God. To live as Christ. Jesus washed feet, says a new command, I give you, love one another as I have loved you. Live like I have loved and lived. I did not come to be served, but to serve, he says. Live as Christ. In our connecting groups, what we desire is to value and to strengthen the call to service. In our vision, connecting people with Jesus Christ and each other through worship, learning, and service, to have fruitful labor, to live as Christ, to be a service-minded people. Lots of different ways we can do that. I keep them ideas and I throw them in a file. And sometimes those ideas are 10 years old, but every once in a while they get used in an appropriate time. One of the ideas that I've been carrying for a while is this idea of maybe our small groups, our connecting groups, or you, writing letters to Christians who are in jail because of their faith. Directly linked to our text today, Paul's encouraged by the fellow brothers who are, and sisters who are praying for him. There are people like Paul in today's world who are standing up for the gospel, living like Christ, and being imprisoned because of it. And the prayers of God's people who are outside the prison walls are powerful and encouraging. Might we not decide to send letters and pray for specific people, Christians, who are in prison for the gospel like Paul is? One example of a service-minded life living, to live like Christ, to have fruitful labor. Our blessing is to be with Christ, that's our promise. Our call is to be like Christ, to have fruitful labor. But this is what Paul actually says. He says, to live, or to die is gain, but to live is Christ. Not to be with Christ or to be as Christ, but is Christ. What does it mean to say living is Christ? That's kind of abstract. To live is Christ. Let's start with Christ. Christ says, I've come to give you life, abundantly to give you life. He rose from the dead. He is about eternal life. Life and light and salvation and blessing. Christ is everything opposite of what Satan has brought into this world, brokenness and darkness and defeat and death. Christ is life. And in Colossians it says that this life that we see around us, all created things, all things, it says, all things are done from Christ, through Christ, and to Christ. Everything we see about life is from Christ, through Christ, to Christ. Do you sense then that this life we live is pervaded, is not the right word, it is blanketed by the gracious presence of Christ and his victory. In him we live and we move and have our being. The breath in your lungs can be done for the glory of Christ because everything, all things, have been redeemed by this Jesus, our Lord and Savior. To live, then, is to be Christ. It is Christ. It's the opposite of Satan. It's to live is to be in victory. To be in the presence of Jesus. I am the bread of life, he says. To live is Christ. Breathing itself is worship. Dear people of God, don't ever consider living your life particularly boring. Don't ever consider it meaningless. Don't ever consider it tedious or trivial, because your life is Christ. You carry Christ in you by virtue of your baptism. You bear his name. The Bible says that where we go, the aroma of Christ goes. You are the temple of the Holy Spirit. The salvation, the redemption that has come across the universe, you carry with you into daily living. Is there anything about that scenario, that picture of life itself, which is tiresome and defeating, dark and filled with death? To live is Christ. Praise be to God. And we're commissioned now to live as Christ. And because of his coming to earth and his death and resurrection, we one day will be with Christ. Praise be to God. In Jesus' holy name. Amen. We stand for a prayer.